Welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of cylinders and pressure vessels. In the previous lecture, we learned about the stresses in thick cylinders. In this lecture, we will try to learn about design of thick cylinders. We have already seen that there exist three types of stresses in a thick cylinder, such as tangential stress, radial stress, and longitudinal stress. All three stresses in thick cylinder are mutually perpendicular. Thus, it is a case of material subjected to triaxial stress. Therefore, various principal stresses can be identified and different theories of failures can be applied to derive the formula for thickness of a thick cylinder. It can be noted from previous lecture that the inner surface of a thick cylinder is the most heavily stressed. Moreover, tangential stress is higher than the radial and longitudinal stress in case of a thick cylinder. Therefore, the first principal stress is equal to tangential stress given by pi dO square plus di square upon dO square minus di square. The second principal stress is equal to radial stress, and that is minus pi. The third principal stress, sigma 3, is equal to longitudinal stress and is given by pi di square upon dO square minus di square. While designing a thick cylinder, first decision has to be made regarding material. Either we can choose brittle material or ductile material. If designer chooses a brittle material, then application of maximum principal stress theory is found to yield better results. If maximum principal stress theory is applied, then the resulting equation is known as Lamé's equation. Maximum principal stress theory states that a material will fail if maximum principal stress in the material exceeds the allowable stress in the material. The Lamé's equation can be seen on the right top hand side corner, given by equation number 1. T is equal to di upon 2 in bracket under root sigma allowable plus pi upon sigma allowable minus pi minus 1 bracket complete. It should be noted that minus 1 term exists outside the radical sign. If ductile material is chosen for the design, then it is observed that maximum principal strain theory yields better results. Application of maximal principal strain theory for closed end vessel results in an equation known as Clavarino's equation. The application differs depending upon end, because in case of closed cylinder, all three stresses are considered, whereas in case of open cylinder, longitudinal stress need not be considered in the analysis. Application of maximum principal strain theory in closed end vessel results in Clavarino's equation, given by equation 2. Application of maximum principal strain theory on open ended vessel by neglecting longitudinal strain results in Bernie's equation, given by equation number 3. All these three equations can be used for calculating thickness of a thick cylinder depending upon material and end of a vessel. In these equations, sigma all stands for allowable stress, which is nothing but ultimate tensile strength divided by factor of safety for brittle material, or yield strength divided by factor of safety for ductile materials. Nu stands for Poisson's ratio, which is a property of a material. In order to understand these concepts, let us solve one numerical example. A hydraulic cylinder made of grey cast iron FG300 is subjected to an internal pressure of 15 MPa. If the inner and outer diameter of the cylinder are 200 mm and 240 mm respectively, determine the factor of safety. The given data can be extracted from the problem as material FG300, internal pressure PI 15 MPa, DI equal to 200 mm, DO equal to 240 mm, and factor of safety is a quantity to be found. If we go through the problem statement carefully, we will realize that gray cast iron is a brittle material. Hence, we have to use Lamé's equation to solve this problem. Observation of this equation will reveal that Di and Pi are the quantities known to us. Whereas thickness can be calculated by using this equation DO minus Di divided by 2, which yields the value of 20. After putting all these known quantities, allowable stress can be calculated as 83.182, which is equal to ultimate tensile strength divided by factor of safety. If we put ultimate tensile strength as 300 in this equation, factor of safety can be calculated as 3.6. And thus, we can solve the problem by using Lamé's equation. Thank you.